Hello folks, in this video we will be building this awesome video conferencing application in React by writing only few lines of code. And how is this possible by writing only few lines? And that is because we will be using ZEGOCLOUD SDK. So what is ZEGOCLOUD? I'll show you, but first let me show you how this application works. So like a normal video conferencing application, it has this following buttons, one for the microphone, one for the camera, and another for screen sharing. So if I turn on the mic, there will be some noise, and that is natural. So I have closed the mic because there is some noise and this is natural. So I can also turn on and off the camera. So my camera is turned off and this is me joined in another browser. So let me turn on the camera and I can also screen share. So here you can go to window and like basically normal screen sharing, you already know this. And also as you can see, there is one messaging bar also. So I can go down and click on the messaging and here I can send any message. So how are you doing? And it will go to the other tab. And here I can also click on the people, and as you can see, two people are joined, and here are some room details if there is any. So, and also I have this URL over here. I can copy this thing, go to another tab, and when this thing opens, I can join as another user. And in the other tab also, as you can see, we are getting these messages and we can also send some messages. So, hey, new user. So I will send this message once the new user joins, and I'll show you that it is also going there. So let me join as Aryan. Join. And as you can see, now there are three people, and let me also close the mic because there will be noise. So let me open the messaging and let me send this one. And as you can see, the new user is getting the new message, but the new user is not getting the old messages. So this is like the normal like Teams or any kind of application where we are talking and also like video streaming with multiple people. So let me write, I'm good. So now that you are getting a good idea how the application works, let me show you how we can do this using ZEGOCLOUD. So what is ZEGOCLOUD? ZEGOCLOUD is a global communication service provider that provides many powerful developer-friendly SDKs and APIs to build many communication features in our apps. And that could be video call, voice call, video conference, etc. So for example, in this video, we'll be building the video conferencing application. And I'd also like to thank ZEGOCLOUD for sponsoring this video. So this is the homepage of ZEGOCLOUD. And if you hover over products, you can see the many kinds of products that you can build. So you can build video call, voice call, live streaming, AIFX, virtual avatar, cloud recording, and many things. So I'll put all the links in the description below. So the first thing that you have to do when you come to ZEGOCLOUD is to create your account, and after that you will get my account. And when I click on this, it will open the admin console for me. So in the admin console, I can create my project, and I will also get like 10,000 free minutes. So that is depending on like how much time you are spending in your apps. And then I will also get many more things, so we can create our project and we can start writing our code. So let's go to VS Code and start creating this app. So in my VS Code, I have already created one minimal React application with two components, app and home. And the home component is being rendered inside the app. Now I will first start working on the home component. So after the H1 tag, I need one input and the type will be text. Then I need one placeholder, enter room ID. This is the room ID of the specific room we are entering. And then we also need the value of the room ID and also an on change. Now we need to define the state variable called room ID to assign the value and the on change. So we will create const room ID, set room ID, and we are using the useState hook for this. So useState, and I will assign the room ID to an empty string. Now there are some issues because we need to put in the values. So here I will assign room ID, and in the onChange, I will have access to an event E, and I want to set the room ID to E.target.value, which is basically whatever we are typing inside the input. Now after the input, we also need one button, and let's name the button as join. And here I need one on click, and I will reference one function called handle join. Now this is gone because we need to create the function handle join. So function handle join, and now we have our app back. So what do we want to do inside the handle join function is we want to navigate to that specific room. So how can we do that? To do that, we need to install React Router DOM first. And inside package.json, I have already installed React Router DOM. So in the terminal, you can simply write npm install React Router DOM and you will have it. And then in the main.jsx, you will need to import browser router. So I will import browser router from React Router DOM. And then I will wrap my app inside the browser router. Now we can start creating our routes. Now we will go back to our app.jsx file, and at the top we will import use navigate, using which we can navigate to a room. Then routes, and also route. Now inside my app component, I am rendering home, but now I want to render based on the path. So I will have routes inside. I will create one base route. So path will only be slash. And when we have the base route, I want to render my home. So now there will be no difference because we are in the base route. But now I will create another route for a room. So path will be slash room and then colon room ID. The colon room ID means this room ID is dynamic, so we can basically pass anything after slash room. And the element we want to render, let's name it room, and we have to create this element, and only then the app will start. So inside my src folder, let me create another file called room.jsx, and here I will write one shortcut rfc, and we will have all of these things. You can install like React shortcuts from the apps, but now let's carry on. Like, it's not a big deal actually. So instead of the div, let me give one h2, and here let me write a room. Now inside my app.jsx, I also have to import the room, and then our app will start. So import room from room. Okay, so now let's see if we can navigate to a room, and we cannot, and that is because we have done nothing inside our handle join. So what we need to do over here, so first of all, I will create const navigate equals to use navigate, and now inside my handle join I can give one path, so navigate, and I will give one backtick, and I want to go to the room slash and the room ID, which is our state variable over here. So now what will happen when I give, let's say, 1, 2, 3, and we are inside this room. So now how can we get this 1, 2, 3 inside the room? We will see now. So inside my room.jsx, I have room, and here I will import use params. So this is another hook that we get from React Router DOM, and using this use params, we can actually access this ID. So how can we do that? So we will write const room ID. And this variable name should be the same as the colon room ID. And here I can simply do like our use params, and we will have our room ID. So after the room, I can simply print my room ID. So we have room 1, 2, 3. So this is how it works. So we have the home page where we will give a room ID and join that specific room. And now we will use ZEGOCLOUD to create the video conference. But before going there, let me also give some minimal styles to this app so that it looks a little bit better. So I will go to my app.css file, which is already being imported in the app.jsx. And here, first of all, in the body section, I will give the font family to this one. Now it already looks a little bit better. And then inside my main, I will give display flex, then flex direction column, and then align item center. So we have everything centered. And now the next thing we want to do is to give some styles to our input. So let me give the width of 250 pixel, it should be px, and then the height of 25 pixel. Let's also increase the font size to 1.25 rem, and let's also give some margin button of 20 pixels. Okay, good enough. Now for the button, let me give the width of 80 pixel and the height of, let's say, 30 pixel. Okay, let's make it 35. Font size I will increase to 1.5 rem. Let's also give the color blue, color of white and background color of blue. So color means the font color. Okay, let's also do border none and border radius of 50%. Okay, let's make it 20 pixel. It is taking 50% from the width. Okay, good enough. And let's also do cursor pointer, and let's also change the font family because buttons have different font families. So let's give the same. Okay, so our minimal styles are done. But now there is another issue, and that is this room is still at the left hand side. So what we can simply do is inside my room.jsx, I will simply give an inline style. So I will do style, and inside I will do text align and then center. Okay, that's all styles we need. So now we will go to our ZEGOCLOUD dashboard. So this is the ZEGOCLOUD dashboard. I have already created two projects for test. In your case, it could be empty. So we will create another project for this video, and there are some options, but I will click on video conference because we are creating one video conference app, and then we will click on next. And then there are two ways to get started. One is with UI kits and the second one is with custom SDKs. So we will first give a name. Let's give the name as video. We cannot give hyphens, so let's give underscore conference app, and then start with UI kits. So now it will take some time to load the project, and meanwhile I want to show you the documentation. So here we have to first install ZEGOCLOUD, ZEGOCLOUD UI kit prebuilt, and then we can create our app. We will need three things. So we will go down. We will need one app ID, which will be generated. We will need one server secret and then one kit token. And with all of these things, we can create our nice looking UI, which is already prebuilt in the ZEGOCLOUD UI kit prebuilt. So in our VS Code, we have to first install this thing by writing this command. Now I have already installed it. So in my package.json, you can see this thing. So in my case, it is already installed. So in my room.jsx file, I have to import this thing, and then we can start creating our UI. So I will simply import ZEGOCLOUD ZEGO UI kit prebuilt from our basically this one, and I will also import v4 from UUID. This is something we will need to generate some random IDs. We will see this later. Now let's go back to our dashboard, and we can see that our app has been created. So let's go to the overview, and we have our video conference app. And here, as you can see, we have one app ID. So in my case, it's already open, but you should keep this secret when you are building an app. So we need this app ID, and we also need this server secret. So in my VS Code, what do we need to do now? So let's write one function. Let's name it async function. And let's name the function as meeting UI, because this is our meeting. This is a function that will start our basically the meeting in this room. And here I will create three variables: app ID, and then my server secret, and then my kit token. So we will have these things, but after we have these things, what do we need? We will create one const called UI, and here I will take my ZEGO UI kit prebuilt, and I will create when UI using the kit token. Then we will simply do UI.joinRoom, and here inside I have to pass element in the container, and this element is actually what we are getting inside the meeting UI. It's basically like a context. So now this has crashed, and that is because we have not filled up these things. And then we also have to pass one scenario, and inside the scenario we will have a mode, and this is basically what kind of app we are building. So ZEGO UI kit prebuilt dot, we are building a video conference, so we will give video conference. Yeah, that's it. So now let's fill up all of these things from our ZEGOCLOUD dashboard. So this is our app ID, so let's copy and paste it over here. Now we have to get our server secret also. So this is the server secret, and I'll copy. And let me also remind you once again that you should definitely not share this with anyone or push it to GitHub. Because of this video, I'm sharing this, but for your case, you will not share this. So let me also paste the server secret as a string. And now what about the kit token? So kit token need to be generated with these things. So ZEGO UI kit, and here I will write generate kit token for test, because this is a test application. And here we need few things. So the first thing that we need is the app ID. The next thing we need is a server secret. And then the third thing that we need is the room ID. And then we need the user ID. And here I will create one random ID, so V4, from the UUID, and this will basically generate one random ID in string format. And then lastly, we need a username. So I will give my name, Arya. So that's all we need. And as you can see, our errors are gone. So now, how can we start the app? To start the app, we will simply come down. And after my H2, I will create one div over here. And here I will give one ref, and I will pass my meeting UI, and our app will start. So as you can see, we are getting one nice looking UI, and it's asking access for my microphone. So let me allow, and it is asking me my name and all of these things. So you can basically give all of this information and it will start the camera. And as you can see, our video conferencing app is ready. So I can click on my microphone, I can turn on and off the camera, and I can also share screen. So everything that you expect to be getting in a video conference app, you are getting using only like few lines of code. So yeah, that's how ZEGOCLOUD is helping us to build this thing so easily. And also, in case you are wondering like how I can write all of these things, and that is because all of these things are basically coming from the documentation. So you can also refer to the documentation and create many kinds of apps. So here, as you can see, after my app ID and everything, so here they are passing my meeting inside the ref, and here, as you can see, all of these things that I have written are actually written over here. So you can basically explore the documentation and try to build many other apps also. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and bye bye.